So my AtGames arcade control deck has just arrived and I've got it installed on my Legends pinball machine. Now I'm going to try to decipher for you, the viewing audience, whether you should get one or not. Now, in terms of fit and function, well, I've got no complaints there because it fits in the exact footprint that the stock control deck did, even with the D-pad and everything. It's great. It's got a low profile joystick, which is a good thing. Typically, you'd want a taller joystick for arcade games, but in this instance, you don't want something super obnoxiously tall because it'd get in the way of you enjoying the actual main purpose of the pinball machine. In fact, I will be the first to admit, when this was first announced, I didn't think I would even care about this. I saw no sense in it. I was like, well, I don't want to play arcade games on my pinball machines. Lo and behold, I started tinkering around with it, started playing some shoot 'em up, some vertical games on this, and I really enjoyed utilizing that 32-inch screen. And then when it came time to do my Simpsons mod, I said, well, wouldn't it be cool if I could play Simpsons Bowling, a game that utilizes a trackball, on this pinball machine. So lo and behold, I found myself needing a control deck with an arcade, you know, style layout and a trackball. So, you know, as luck would have it, AtGames already made it. So I knew I had to get it. So that's when I placed my order. Now, the joystick itself uses an 8-way octagonal restrictor gate underneath it. If you want to play some more dedicated games like Pac-Man, Miss Pac-Man, that type of thing that are, you know, definitely suited for a 4-way style joystick, well, then you'll probably want to swap this out. However, if you want to play more versatile games, more advanced games that have that diagonal direction, then you just want to leave it as is. The buttons themselves, I got no complaints other than the fact that the micro switches are actually pretty noises, but the buttons perform and feel pretty decent. The trackball feels much better than the stock trackball that was on the ALU 1.0. I think they've got better reinforcements in here. It just feels more sturdy, more stable. It doesn't have that kind of side-to-side wiggle that the ALU was a little bit guilty of. And it also doubles as a mouse if you got a PC connected via OTG or something like that, which is great because I'm used to using these little wireless keyboards anytime I have a PC mod. But now I can actually use this as my mouse cursor when I've got my computer plugged in, and then I could use my action buttons as my enter or whatever, right click, left click, you know. So essentially I can get rid of this now and just use my trackball and my action buttons and the joystick. But every game I've tested thus far, whether it be shooters, vertical arcade games, horizontal games up here on the top screen, because I've been playing the Simpsons arcade game, of course, as well as the Simpsons bowling game, absolutely phenomenal experience. Like I said, I'm really happy I went this route. Now, the price tag on this MSRP is $200. They were offering an early bird discount, if you will, for their National Owners Day, which you could purchase this for $100. Me personally, I think this is much more in line with a $100 purchase than a $200 purchase. It's all well and good, but I think $200 is probably a bit much. So if you don't have an immediate need for it, I'd say maybe wait until the next sale comes around, because somewhere around the $100 price point is definitely where this thing should be. Installation of this new control deck could not be any simpler. I'm not even going to waste your time showing you how to do it, because it's literally remove the stock control deck, put this new one inside. You're going to take the USB cable that is just sitting there unused at the bottom of the ALP machine. You're going to plug that into the backside of this. You're going to disconnect the stock exciter wire. You're going to plug it into this one right here, make that connection, connect those two cables, and then you're good to go. We do have new and improved exciters here. So the left and the right hand side, we do have those new exciting exciters. Yes, totally made a dad joke, made a pun, but seriously, the new exciters in here are much more pronounced, much more punchy, much more bassy, and just much more haptically friendly for your pinball games. I mean, you definitely feel it so much more pronounced in your palms when you're resting them on the machine and playing them, and they're not distracting, they're not rattling, they're not buzzing. I've seen all sorts of issues with the stock OEM ones, so these appear to be a much better quality and a much better performing exciter overall for your pinball haptic experience.